Bristol Community College Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.1, Problem 2. This is Section 4.1, Problem 2. It says, write the initial simplex tableau for the problem shown below. And we have a problem that says, maximize z equals 10x1 plus 15x2 plus 10x3 plus 5x4 subject to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 300. x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 360. And then x1 is greater than or equal to 0, x2 is greater than or equal to 0, x3 is greater than or equal to 0, and x4 is greater than or equal to 0. So essentially by saying write the initial simplex tableau, they're saying change this into a matrix. Is essentially what it means. So to change it into a matrix, the problem we have is a matrix is a group of equations and we have some linear inequalities. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to focus on my first constraint, which is x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 300, and convert that from a linear inequality into a linear equation. So to do that, I am going to keep x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4, but now I'm going to do plus, not just s for slack, but s1. And then I'm going to leave a little bit of a space, and now I'm going to put equals 300 instead of less than or equal to. By adding the s1, it allows me to convert the less than or equal to that was originally in the constraint into an equal to make it a linear equation. Now my second constraint of x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 plus x4 is less than or equal to 360, I'm going to change that into a linear equation by adding a different slack variable. So I'm going to get x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 plus x4 plus s2. I'm not going to put the s2 directly beneath the s1. And I'm going to make that equals now 360 instead of less than or equal to 360. Now, for two constraints, you need two separate slack variables because most likely you'll need a different amount of slack. The top equation that we have now might need a slack of 2, whereas the bottom equation might need a slack of, say, 8. You can't count on them, so you can't use the same S for both. It has to be a different S. Now, the constraints that have the greater than or equal to 0 do not need to go into the matrix. I don't have to change those into equations. I don't need them. But what I do need is the object function has to be part of my matrix or initial simplex tableau. Now, it already is an equation. If you notice, the object function is z equals 10x1 plus 15x2 plus 10x3 plus 5x4. So I don't have to put a slack variable in it. But the problem is, my other equations that I'm going to have as part of the matrix that we just added some slack to have all the x variables on the left side of the equal sign, whereas this one equation that I'm using as my object function has the x variables on the right side, the other side of the equal sign. Now, if they're just written as a group of equations, you can write them any way you want. But when you turn into a matrix, they all have to line up. So since everything else, every other equation that I'm going to have in my matrix starts with x1, my object function has to start with x1. So I can put that x1 at the beginning, at the far left side of my equation, and when I go to the left side of the equal sign, it's going to become negative 10x1. Now the next thing I need to have to make it line up with the other equations I have is x2. So in my object function, I have 15x2, but it's on the right side of the equal sign. To bring it to the left side, it will just convert to negative 15x2. And then the next part of my object function is 10x3. Again, I want to bring it to the left side of my equal sign, so it'll line up with the x3s that I have in all the other equations I'm using. So it'll go to the left and become negative 10x3. And finally, the last piece is 5x4. Again, I want to line it up with the other equations I'm going to be putting into my matrix, so it has to go to the left side of the equal sign, so it'll become negative 5x4. Now, for the other equations where I had to add slack, there's no need for me to add a slack variable for this one because it already has an equals. But it has a new variable that the other equations didn't have. It has a z, so I can't just forget about that and let it go. This equation has a z, I have to mention it. Now equals, now what's left on the right-hand side after I've moved everything from the right over to the left would be a 0. Now, everything in my problem is written as an equation, and it's written in such a way that all the variables line up. If all my x1's first, then my x2's, my x3's, my x4's, a few s's, and I have a z, then all my equals line up, then I have just the numbers with no variables. Now I can turn it into a matrix. So let me just move over a little bit to the right, or I can fit a matrix underneath here. Let's fit the matrix underneath, and let's even do it in a different color so it doesn't get mixed with the equations. Now, you don't really have to label the columns, but I think it's worth doing. So I'm going to have an x1 column in my matrix, an x2 column in my matrix, an x3 column, an x4 column. There is no x5, but I'm going to have an s1 column in my matrix, an s2 column in my matrix. I'll have a z column. And then on the other side of the equal sign, I typically label this RHS for right-hand side. And then we'll put a line. And now the top equation, this x1, I just want the number in front, which isn't actually written, but you can figure it's a 1. The 1x2, the number in front is a 1. The 1x3, the number in front is a 1. The 1x4, the number in front is a 1. The 1s1, the number in front is a 1. S2 is next. There is no S2 in the top equation. I can't leave it blank when it's a matrix, so I put in a 0 for S2. Same thing for Z. I have to put in a value for Z next in the top row of my matrix. There is no Z in my top equation, so I put in a 0. And then right-hand side is 360. So the first equation is done. Now the next equation, 1x1 will give me a 1, 2x2 will give me a 2, 3x3 will give me a 3, 1x4 will give me a 1. S1 is next as I fill in my matrix. There is no S1 in the second equation, so S1 in the second row gets a 0. S2 does get a 1 because it's 1s2. The next thing I fill in is Z. There is no Z in the second equation, so in my second row I put in a 0. And right-hand side gets a 360. The top one should have been 300. Glad I caught that. Fix that easily. The top one should have been 300 for right-hand side. It's the second row that's 360. Now, the bottom equation is going to make the bottom row of my matrix. The negative 10x1 will be negative 10. You have to include the sign, the negative. So the x2 column of my matrix will have a negative 15 for the bottom row. The x3 column of my matrix will have a negative 10. And then the x4 column of my matrix for the bottom row will have a negative 5 from the negative 5x4. And now S1 and S2 in the bottom row of my matrix will be 0 because my bottom equation doesn't have an S1 or an S2. The Z for the bottom row of my matrix will have a 1. And the right-hand side for the bottom row of my matrix will have a 0. And now that's the first matrix or initial simplex tableau for the problem in number 2.